I know that. Many of us are getting ready for God reclaim my glory. That we start tomorrow. I pray for you in the name of the Lord.
And
all the glory that the enemy has stolen away. In the name of Jesus the Lord, we reclaim it for you and me. Amen. Let your amen have fire. All the glory that darkness has taken away, as from tonight, for you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Those 3-day programs will be powerful. I know everyone that wants to partake in it, that we are going together. This will be a different time in your life. Please have it in your mind before you embark on the journey that I'm going to reclaim my glory. When you want to reclaim glory from the enemy, it is not just an easy task. We are talking about glory here. Don't go there and go and jolly with other people. When you get there tomorrow and or next tomorrow and on Sunday, please don't play with those 3 days so that you can reclaim that glory for yourself. I pray for you with 3 powerful amen if you can do it. The enemy that is holding up your glory, no matter how powerful they might be, in the name of Jesus, fall from heaven.
He
splashed down from heaven to heaven. Amen. I was going through the Bible recently.
Genesis 3.
The book of Genesis chapter 3.
Verse 13 to 16.
Verse 13 to 16.
Genesis chapter 3. Verse 14 to 16.
Genesis ori keta eseketa la si esekeni dilogu. And the Lord told the woman that, what have thou done? And the woman answered, it was the serpent that deceived me. This is not man that deceived her. It was the serpent that deceived the woman. Please let us try to stand on our knees, please, on our foot. Let's read that verse again. And the Lord asked the woman, what have you done? And the woman said, the serpent deceived me. It is not human being that deceived her, it is just the serpent. Don't deceive her. And the Lord spoke to the serpent, because you have done this, because are you above all livestock and all the beasts of the field? And on your belly shall you go, and thus shall you eat all the days of your life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Tonight is not a joking prayer. Two people might come together and one person can have a better understanding than you. Your friend might come to play, but I want to know why you are here. What will be the theme of the prayer tonight? Will be powerful a little bit.
Verse 14.
The verse 14.
Oh, right.
Serpent,
because
you have done this,
because
are you the beast of the field,
and
on his belly shall go, and
thou
shalt the snake eat all the days of the life of the serpent. I pray for you, any person like a serpent around you,
Jesus.
Amen.
Verse 15.
I will put enmity between you and the woman. offspring and our offspring. He shall bruise his head and bruise his
heel. Hallelujah.
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 Do you know there are many people, there are numerous serpents around you that are human beings? They are just covering themselves with the human clothing. They are beasts like snakes. The snake does not have any benefit to do to you than to deceive you. Eve and Adam. There is no good that is snake which you do. Just to deceive you. Or to bruise you by the heel. And anyone that is invented by snake, no matter how they start, they will stagger and fall. I pray for you in the name of the Lord. Do you know human beings can be enmity to themselves as well? I don't want you to negate yourself. Pray progressively as we are going. Delilah was the snake-like person behind Samson. As powerful as Samson was in his journey, and the serpent was Delilah. Until Samson was blinded, she did not go back. She did not go back until they took away his Nazarene. And that Delilah was the snake of his life. There's no death like the death of the woman that killed a powerful man. When you have glory, you are a man. Be careful of women. Because you are not careful of the women. You are going to lose your glory on that. Every snake,
pray for you.
Women, endeavor to pray for your husband.
So
that by the time the glory is emanating, you will not be like you don't know how to do.
Pray for woman,
pray for your male children. So that they will not go and mismarry the wrong woman. They were asking Samson. Yes. Delilah was asking Samson. You truly love me. What can be done unto you that you will become a strange man and you will be powerless? What can be done to you? Don't destroy your life. What can be done to you?
Let it sweat your kune alai labana.
Render you powerless.
Samson alai no ye.
And Samson was a foolish human being. He was given all kinds of description. He was lying to Delilah initially. That is where he should have gotten the message. I pray for you.
Where
that snake
is
asking and finding
a place.
In your life.
I know.
Delilah was asking Samson the journey about his life or the question about his destiny. What will we do to you? Samson, your life is
poor.
The morning of the second day, Delilah told the spies and told them, do like this to
him
and just fight. Rob him and bind him. And they shouted something. The Philistines are here. He shook his body and that bond cut loose. He is not like Jesus.
Jesus
told the devil today, please, how to pray. Who is that snake?
Yeah.
In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. That sister from Canada, I'm sure she'll be looking at the live stream. On a job, that woman will be questioning her. How did you go about this thing? You did this one very well. But when the boss comes, she will say something different. She'll be antagonizing her. Then I told her, pray one day prayer. Every serpent people that surround you on your job, that God should smash their head.
Oh Lord,
the sister went that day. She had peace of mind that she will take our sister's job from her. But this woman had prayed ahead. When she got to that boss to antagonize our sister, and the boss said, why are you always gossiping about this lady? You are the one that we are going to terminate, not her.
God smash her head. You know, midwives are the ones that want somebody labor, they want to give birth, they are the ones that will save delivery of the child. That's midwife. That is the job of the midwife. Is that not it? Yes. After a while, they will give the newborn back to the I think my good was in June,
but the house still in the way.
You are stealing it.
You are stealing it.
You are
swallowing it.
You are swallowing it.
Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. Please let us pray. All the enemies will make me pain out of good things. But you allow me to see the good things. Two people have deliverance. Just two people, please pray. Two people have deliverance right now. Please, the man of God to repeat that prayer. Lord, deliver me from death. From the fires that hold my life bound.
Deliver. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. The Bible or the scripture says the people were in one accord. The Bible says they were in with one accord or a language that was similar. And they were in one word. That means they were indivisible. They were in unity.
Now
I want to pray. Every enemy unified on my land, let fire go through them. Every enemy in unity against my children, against my husband, against my wife, against my children.
When they hold hands,
in the matter,
three people, when they hold hands,
in the marriage,
four people, when they hold hands,
in the marriage,
I'm talking about 10 people now, when they are in cooperation, if fire wants to go through them, can they stop the fire? They will go away from the fire. What will happen? They will let go of their hands. They are going to pray. Any enemy that
ties
hands on my marriage, on my children, on my
wife,
you're going to call the name of Jesus. Please don't be lukewarm. You that the sword of God is pursuing. Those people that the sword of God is pursuing. And now you are coming towards my life. God, cast them to the fire. Look at it. Sword is pursuing them. And the person is coming towards you. Now God will cast them towards the fire.
You can see that Saul is pursuing that person, and the person is coming towards you. By the time the person got to you, fire, God used fire to send them away. Those that Saul is pursuing, and they are now coming to my
house.
Fire pursuing them away.
Those who know your door.
Anyone that because they have been bewitched, they want to bring their problem upon me. Those that they want to use their bondage and they want to affect my
life.
Those people that they are carrying yoke on the
vessel
and they want to bring their yoke into
me.
But
you
are turning on tomorrow. Please, let's step forward, please. If you are back there, let's pray three prayers more. Raise your right hand, please. You say, God said, the Lord of hosts, for the rest of this year, I must not be with
you.
Amen. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Amen. You can go back to your seat.